Hey guys, welcome back in TypeScript 5 for Absolute Beginner series. In lecture 8, we will talk about advanced TypeScript types and its features. And this lecture will cover union and intersection types, type guards and type narrowing, generics, mapped and conditional types. First, let's talk about union and intersection types. Union type allows a variable to have one of several types, and intersection type combine multiple types into one. Now let's see the coding example of these types. Let's create union type. First I need to write type keyword and then define its name. Cause this union type can accept number or string data type. Next I'm going to write a function which can print both number or string. And I'm going to pass number or string union type as a parameter. Now either I can pass number to this print function or string to this function, and it can print both number or string. But if I try to pass boolean value to this function, then it will show an error. Why? Because this data type is not included in our union type. But if I also want to pass boolean value in this function, then I need to add boolean data type in its union type. So a union type describes a value that can be one of several types, and we use a vertical bar to separate each type. Next we have intersection type. To understand this intersection type, first I'm going to create a type name, in which I have name of type string, and type age, in which I have age of type number. Now I'm going to combine these both the types in type name and age equal name and age. This is called our intersection type. Next, let's implement this name and age intersection type. Let person name and age. Now I need to declare these both the types name and age. So an intersection type combines multiple types into one. This allows you to add together existing types to get a single type that has all the features you need. Next, let's talk about type guards and type narrowing. Type guards are custom checks you create to determine the type of a variable at runtime. While TypeScript can automatically define the type of a variable based on control flow, like if statements or switch cases. This is called type narrowing. Let's clear this concept by a coding example. First, I'm going to create union type. Next, I'm going to write the function println, and in its params, I'm going to pass this union type, number or string. In console.log, if I want to print value.length, then it's not showing us any string properties. Why? Because TypeScript have no idea what it's receiving from the parameter, either it's number or string. So first I need to define the type guard. For type guard, I'm going to write a function. Function is string, and its param I'm going to pass union type, number or string. Now this function will return us boolean value, and for that I need to write a predicate param is string and return type of param is equal to string. So it will return true if our parameter will be string. And this is the way we implement type guards. Now by applying type narrowing in println function, we can get the properties of string. If is string value console.log length, and now I can get the property length here, value.length. And in this if block, we will get all the properties of string. And in else block, we can get the number value. Now let's pass the values in println function to see how this type guard and type narrowing works. Let's build and run our application to see the output window. As you can see, first it prints the else block when we pass number value, and in second it prints length of the string. So a type guard is some expression that performs a runtime check that guarantees the type in some scope using type predicates. While type narrowing follows possible paths of execution that our programs can take to analyze the most specific possible type of a value. Then we have generics. Generics in TypeScript provide a way to create reusable and flexible components, functions, or classes without sacrificing type safety. Let's see its example, class person. And in this class, I want to pass its ID at runtime. So, ID equal template, whose I want to initialize type of ID at time of object creation. Name of type string. Now I need to initialize these both the values in constructor. ID of type template, name of type string, and this dot ID is equal to ID, and this dot name is equal to name. And this is our generic class, and I can use this person class for any kind of class where I need to define my ID at object creation. Let person1 equal new person, and here I want my ID of type number 1 test user. After defining my ID type number, I can't pass the value of type string or any other type. Then it will definitely show an error. So generics play an important role in TypeScript as it allows us to write reusable code that accepts both values and types as arguments. Then we have mapped and conditional types. Map types are used to create new types by transforming properties of existing types, while conditional types used to define a type based on a condition or type relationship. Let's create map types. Map type we create on an existing type. First, I have a type of person in which I have name of data type string and age of data type number. Now, if I want to make this person property is read only, then I will write another type read only person, and in parentheses. Now what I actually want, I want to make these all the properties of person read only. So let's write this read only keyword, and in this parentheses k in key of person colon person key. Now what this code will do, this will iterate all the properties of person type and makes them read only. This is the way actually we implement our map types. For example, let's create a person object. Let person 1 person and define its properties name person 1 and age 12. Now if I want to change the age value, person1.age is equal to 14, this will not show any error. But if I want that all my properties must be read-only, then I will use this read-only person. So let's create another object. Let person2 read-only person, and in this I am going to define name person2 and age 12. Now if I will change person2.age, then it will show an error because now all the properties are read-only. So map types are a way to create new types based on another type. Then we have conditional types. Type number or string, and in this parenthesis I need to define template is equal to t extends number, then it will give us number type, otherwise string. So conditional types are non-uniform type mappings. In other words, they are type transformations that differ depending on a condition. Hope you understand these all minor but very important concepts. If you have any question or query, you can ask in comments. But if this lecture is helpful for you, then guys, please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thanks for watching.